Hey guys, and welcome back to Inside Investing. And today we're going to be discussing the VWRL All World ETF, and specifically which big companies are included in this ETF. So let's go. So guys, this is the current value of the VWRL ETF. So this is the Vanguard All World ETF. We've quickly taken a screenshot from the Giro, which you can see right on screen now. So this is the current value, trading at around €103.88. That is close to its all-time high, which is around €104.30. So we're getting close again. There was a little bit of a dip the last couple of weeks, as you can see here. But now, as of now, it's going quite well. Also looking back at the last year's performance, so that's, we've put a filter on the last year actually right there, you can see that it has a very stable increase. So it went from lowest point of like €77 all the way up to above €100. So that's very significant, guys. VWRL is doing very well the last couple of years. If you also want to start investing, then as you know, please use the Giro. Please use our link down in the description to also start your investment journey today. Then quickly having a look at the biggest companies that are included, and there are currently more than 3,700 companies, so it's very difficult for us to go through all of them, but these are at least the biggest ones and the most interesting ones for us as well, which are Tesla, Facebook, Amazon as well, Microsoft, Apple, and also Google, and I think these are at least the biggest companies. But now we can also have a look at the sectors that are included in VWRL. So right on screen now, you can see the sectors that are included in VWRL. We see technology at the top of the list, so that's 23%. So that's a lot, right? There's a big focus on technology, of course. Then we've got consumer discretionary, we've got financials, industrials, healthcare, consumer staples, and then after that, it's all very small, but I think at least it's very good that it's all included. So energy as well, basic materials, telecommunications, real estate, and the last one, utilities, making up of 100% of this VWRL. And this is weighted exposure as of the 30th of September 2021. So that's the most recent date that they came out with. And then we can have a look at the list. So this is the list, the top 10 funds in VWRL. So right on screen now, you can see as of the 30th of September again, how significant these companies are included. So we see Apple 3.2%, Microsoft 3.1%, Amazon 2.1%, Facebook 1.1%, Alphabet, so that's the mother company of Google, that's 1.1% twice, and we've got Tesla for 0.9%. Semiconductors, Taiwan Semiconductors Manufacturing, Nvidia, and JP Morgan and Chase are also all on the first page. And you see in total currently 3,742 companies are included. So that's a lot of different companies, guys. This is very nicely balanced across the full market, so that's very good. And quickly showing you the Vanguard website itself. So this is the website of Vanguard, and right here you can go to portfolio data, and right here we can see the companies, and as well we can see a little bit more of the data. This is also where we pulled our data from. So we see a significant focus on the Northern Americas. We see Europe as well, Pacific, and emerging markets. I think that's always very good. So that's 10.6% as well on emerging markets. So that's very nice. I think all of this data is of the 30th of September, just so you know. Market allocation. So if you look to specific companies, we see the US, we see Japan, China, the UK, France as well, Canada. So a lot of different countries actually are included, all the way down to countries that are very small included, for example Poland or the Philippines. Then this is what I showed you earlier. So this is the sectors that are included, the holdings. Yeah, and actually here we can go through all of these pages, guys. There's a lot of different pages, but Johnson & Johnson, we see Visa, we see Berkshire Hathaway, Home Depot, Nestle, Walt Disney, Netflix, Alibaba, so all of these companies are included, guys. I'll quickly just click through it for you just so that you can see the companies included, but just know that there's a lot of exposure to a lot of different companies. I think this is one of the most companies that I've seen included in one ETF, so that's very nice, very well balanced, I would say. And you see real, this is quite some pages to click through, so we're not going to be doing that, but just know that this is very well balanced and you're actually leveraging the full market in this, so that's very nice. So we hope that that at least gave you a little bit more background into the companies that are included in VWRL. And guys, if you also want to start investing, then definitely subscribe, because if you subscribe, then we can keep you up to date, we can keep you informed on what's happening currently in the market, on why we're investing in certain ETFs. And that's, as you know, we're very heavy invested in ETFs. That's the only thing we're currently doing. So if you want to see us continue to improve and continue our portfolio to expand, then definitely remember to subscribe and like the video as well. That also helps out the channel grow. And then I think for the upcoming period, just know that VWRL is going to be the backbone of our portfolio. We're going to be buying way more VWRL in the upcoming future. So if you want to see our portfolio growing, then definitely hit the subscribe button as well. Thank you for watching this episode, and we see you in the next one, guys. Let's go.